Hey, Simmers and Animal Lovers, it's Erin the Rescue Simmer, and I believe that pets make our life better, so I am going around to each of the towns and making over any townie that did not have a pet. It is January out here in the real world, the month of New Year's resolutions, and for this month, we are here in beautiful San Myshuno. When I think of San Myshuno, I think of San Francisco, I think of New York, those towns that you go to, those big cities to make your dreams happen. I feel like those are cities that are like born of New Year's resolutions. So there are 8 families here in San Myshuno. Today, we're going to be focusing on 4 of them. For our first household, we're going to go to the Medina Studios apartment to see probably the saddest household as far as like living conditions, and we're going to meet the Benali family. So Salim has grown up in the arts quarter, surrounded by poets, musicians, and artists. He's determined to become a great writer right after he's finished that book, Oh, and That Video Game He Needs to Beat. Come to think of it, he needs an app too. So this guy is kind of all over the place, all over the map. He has a goal. He definitely wants to accomplish it. So let's pop into Create a Sim to get this guy a furry friend that may help him prioritize just a little bit. So Salim is a household that I feel like he's on the cusp of getting his stuff together, right? I feel like it's one of those steps that you take when you're at that point in life to like get a pet, like get something whose life wouldn't be as good if you didn't try so hard. Now, Salim does have some traits that we need to take into account here. So he absolutely wants to be a best-selling author. He struggles a little bit with motivation. He is lazy, which is, I mean, all of us at some point, definitely me on some days. He is a bookworm, he loves his books, and he's creative. So this does not seem to me like a very active guy. I'm going to rule out a dog for him. Dogs need to be taken out of the apartment multiple times a day, no matter what the weather, rain, sleet, or shine, to use the potty. I don't care who you are, apartment dwellers, it is not okay to let your dogs go on a pee-pee pad. Not full-grown adult dogs peeing on your floor. No thank you. So with that knowledge, knowing that we're gonna be looking for a cat, oh my gosh, we should ask ourselves what kind of cat he would like. I feel like Salim would gravitate toward a more scruffy cat. So this is a Cornish Rex. That actually might be a really good option for him. Most cats have 3 layers of fur. Cornish Rexes only have 1 layer. They have like a kind of like a down layer, and it doesn't shed very much. So they're gonna be less maintenance. I think just feeding the cat will be a big thing for him. I think he'll do it, and I think he'll love the cat. I like the vibe of this guy. I'm gonna grab that Cornish Rex coat because I think it is so cute, and pop it on this Devon Rex. So you may be asking yourself like what the difference is between the Cornish Rex and then the Devon Rex that we have here that we sort of put this Cornish Rex coat on. Cornish Rexes are described just very generally as dog-like cats that can be handled pretty easily by children. They are very playful, incredibly responsive cats. They kind of want to get up and go. Devon Rexes are more refined, they're more regal, they hold back a little bit more, they're just a quieter overall breed. So I think that they would be much better fit for Salim. This Devon Rex has 2 more traits that we have to give them. So this guy is clever, so he's gonna learn fast. I think it's gonna be important for Salim because Salim does not keep going with things. So if the training's not easy, I think he would drop it. Bless his buttons, he tries, but he's focused on writing a book. We can also give this cat the aloof trait. Although he may want his owner's affection and attention every once in a while, I think it's good for him to be able to want to kind of occupy himself, do things by himself. But I would like him to be playful so that, again, he encourages Salim sort of out of his funks to be able to give his cute cat some attention. And I think pets tend to reflect their owners. Like, their owners have a style. So let's take a look. Salim, I'm seeing a lot of, not a whole lot of consistency in color. I am seeing some dark blues and reds. Those kinds of colors kind of peek out. So I think we'll focus on that actually for him. I like the dark blue, I think, better in this. And I like this collar better. It just seems like a no fuss, no muss kind of collar. And I think that that's where Salim would take this. Salim's name, Salim Benali, is actually an Arabic name. And as we saw, as I was going through his wardrobe, he actually has style that is an American-influenced version of some traditional Islamic wear. So I think that he would be pretty inspired by his heritage, by his culture. There are actually some amazing Islamic writers. One of them is, and I'm going to butcher this, I'm so sorry, is Imru al-Qais. And again, I'm not pronouncing it as anything other than an American because that's the language that I'm reading it in. But I think that he would want to be inspired by his new pet, so he would name him Imru. And of course, we're going to give him Salim's last name. So there we have little Imru Benali. Perfect. Look at how motivated he seems already. On to the next household. For our next household, we are going to Hakim House Apartments, to the Zhang household. Bako and Anya came to the bustling city of San Myshuno so Bako could broaden his career as a rising comedian and so Anya could get clarity on which of her passions to focus on as her career, inspiring songstress or successful painter. Their quirky kiddo, Billy, is happy to be along for the ride. This social butterfly has no filter when it comes to making new friends, even if that involves barging uninvited into their neighbor's apartments. So that's a little concerning. Definitely, I think we're going to need to give Billy a reason to stay in her own apartment and safe and not like asking to be taken. So let's pop into Create a Sim and give them their furry friend. Oh my gosh, Anya is so pretty. So it looks like she wants to be a muser and her lifetime aspiration is to be a painter. She does love music, she loves art, and she's romantic. That is so sweet. Bako has a lifetime aspiration to be a joke star. He is family oriented, which is so sweet. He's goofy and he loves music as well. And then we have cute little Billy. She is a social butterfly, as it mentions in the bio, and she's a goofball. So it looks like she's taking more after her dad right now. And I don't know about you guys, but yellow seems to be the theme for these guys. I think all of these Sims have a really great personality to be able to take on a pet. They could do a cat, they could do a dog. I specifically for Billy see a dog. I think that she's going to need a little buddy that she can take out walking everywhere, that she can be responsible for, that she can put all of this uber friendly energy into. Oh my gosh, this is a cute little dog. Now, they are apartment livers. Most apartments have either a 20 pound limit or a 30 pound limit if they allow pets at all. So I would want to give them a smaller dog. The one that I'm actually thinking for them is a Basenji. Basenjis do not bark. That doesn't mean they don't make noise. They have this like yodel baby cry thing. So you have to warn your neighbors. They're very curious dogs. They're bouncy. They tend to be pretty good with kids. So I think a Basenji would be perfect. Oh my gosh, so beautiful. I think this is a pretty flashy coat. I do like that. So this dog pops in with the sleuth trait. And I think that fits pretty well with their family. I think I would really like to give this dog the loyal trait. And Billy and Bako are goofy. So I want to give this animal a trait that would complement that. I think either playful or friendly. I think I'm going to go with friendly because they're going to want to meet people quite a bit, or at least Billy will. And I think that they would let Billy pick this dog's name. Billy is goofy, so I think that she would name her something like Bubbles, something that made her happy to say. And of course, last name Zhang. Last but not least, let's give a collar. I think yellow is this family's color, that is for sure, so why break it with Bubbles? Bubbles would be Billy's play friend. I think that she would be dressed up by Billy, and why not give her a unicorn horn? Oh my gosh, Billy looks happier already. On to the next household. So next on our ambitious January New Year's resolution families are the Fangs. They live in the Landgrab Apartments. Their bio is pretty short, but packed with drama. So Victor is a respected and high-powered politician. Lily is a tough businesswoman. Their respectful yet somber nature masks their sinister secret plans to one day take over San Myshuno. Oh my gosh, you guys. So this is definitely a power couple. I think that anything that they own would reflect that. And I have a pretty clear idea of who I want for them. So Miss Lily, who is paying beautiful homage to her Chinese heritage, wants to be a mansion baron. She has the business savvy trait because, again, she is a businesswoman. She hates children, so no kids for them. She is a genius and she's unflirty. So she is a very serious, somber lady. Victor just wants to be fabulously wealthy. He also has the business savvy trait. He is also a genius, but he's a perfectionist and he's materialistic. So I would agree that they don't need kids, but you know what? Everybody needs a dog or cat. And for these guys, I think that they would hearken back to their Chinese heritage. I think that they are very proud of that. So I think a Shar Pei would be absolutely beautiful for them. Now, the Shar Pei breed is a Chinese breed, but it was almost brought to extinction. In the 70s, there was a big revival of them in the US. So I think what Victor and Lily would do was that they would take a Shar Pei, not an American Shar Pei, I think they would take a Chinese Shar Pei with Chinese lines, and they would actually import the dog over from China. They definitely have the funds to do that. I think that it would absolutely communicate power for them. Although Lily doesn't want children, I think that this would be her baby. And you know what, guys? I'm actually thinking that this isn't Shar Pei looking enough, not Chinese Shar Pei looking enough. So I will bet that the gallery has some amazing things for us. Oh, see guys, this is what I'm talking about. This Shar Pei has that sort of velvet looking texture that they're really known for. This Shar Pei was uploaded by Cameron Lineage, and we're just gonna pop them into game and have some fun. It looks like the original uploader has named this Shar Pei Sumo. Oh my goodness. And this is a male. I don't disagree with that at all. I think though that I'm gonna change his name to Bao. Their last name Feng has a few different translations, but one of them is Phoenix. So it gives this image of like rising from ashes, very powerful. And Bao means treasure. So I think that that's exactly what he would be to them. I love the texture that Cameron Lineage used on this dog. They have this very velvety kind of look to their wrinkles and rolls. Like you just want to pet them and they would be so soft, but that couldn't be further from the truth. Their name Shar Pei actually translates to something like sand coat or sandpaper, something like that. And that is way more indicative of how their coat feels. It feels very, very rough and bristly. I want to go with a little bit of a different collar. I like this collar. I think they would go with red. This looks to me like there are studs on it. I think they would take a ton of pride in their little boy. This dog would have to be smart. I think I agree with stubborn. So to Victor and Lily, he would be obedient. He would be able to do things the first time he was asked. But to anyone else, I don't think he would listen worth a hill of beans. Ooh, and you guys, I think we're going to use this pet Archimedes by Whitaker05 as our female Shar Pei, because I definitely think that they would have a breeding pair. And I think we're going to name her Lian because it translates apparently to lotus. I don't know how exact the translation is, but that's what Google thinks. Yes, let's give you a white collar, white studded collar. I love the wrinkles on her face. Typically when you're breeding Shar Pei, the more wrinkles you can get, the more valuable the dog is, because that's one of their defining features. It can cause huge skin issues. So if you are looking for a Shar Pei specifically, just for health reasons, I would probably go for one that does not have such exaggerated wrinkles. Now, I think, honestly, I agree with all of these character traits. I think that would be great ones for Lian to have. Perfect. The fangs are looking like a fuller house with some very powerful dogs to be able to conquer this city. Last but not least, we are going to the Alto Apartments to visit Mr. Lobo. This is Diego Lobo. This is the guy that makes your New Year's resolutions happen if you are an aspiring artist. So established and novice artists alike shudder in anticipation for the day Diego Lobo steps in his critical foot to their gallery. Impress him and you'll have it made for life. But if one brush stroke is off, if just one hue is not quite to his liking, you may never work in this town again. Oh my gosh. So this man has incredibly high standards. He knows what he is looking for. He knows talent. And if you don't have it, he will let everybody know. So let's pop into Create a Sim and see what pets would be best for him. So here is Diego Lobo looking fabulous, always. His traits are that he wants to be fabulously wealthy. He is a hothead. He loves art and he is a snob. So he likes the finer things, definitely. Now, anytime my Sims have interacted with Diego Lobo, he's always been really nice. So I choose to interpret him as not mean, just very particular. As you can see, this man has an eye for color. He has an eye for style. His name makes me think that he has some Latin American heritage and that either this is natural, although this is so shockingly blonde, I'm betting it's bottle, because he knows what aesthetic he is going for. And he is completely versatile in whatever he wears. He has many, many looks. Oh my gosh. We are going to give him a dog that has beautiful bone structure, because I think that would be absolutely up his alley. I don't get cat vibes from him. I think he would want something that could go out and make appearances with him. And I think the world is better set up for dogs to be strolling with their owners than it is with cats. A Borzoi might be an option. Like, their bone structure is gorgeous. They have that beautiful Roman nose. They have these stretched kind of features. I think they'd be a beautiful backdrop for all the fashion he's gonna put these guys in. They do seem a little hairy, which is fine. I mean, they have gorgeous coats, but for Diego, I don't think he would like that. I think that he would want something pretty exclusive. I think that he would want something gorgeous as a backdrop to put fashion on. Probably this menu is not going to help Southmost. I think we're going to go back to the gallery for a very specific breed. So this is a rare breed, especially in the US, and I think that that would be the big draw for him. I'm only going to say the name once because I am not 100% on how to say this. Sholowens Quintley is how I interpret we say it. You can shorten it though to Sholo Dog, or Mexican Hairless is the US way to say it. Now, these dogs come in three sizes. They come in a standard version, they come in a miniature version, and they come in a toy version. So standard would be like a large dog, miniature would be a small dog, and toy would be even smaller than that. We don't have the ability to do that, but I think that he would own as many varieties as he possibly could, because why limit yourself on fashion choices? So I am looking for this speckled skin, and I think that this dog is perfect for that. And upon looking, I know you're saying, ew, gross. I get it. But I think that Diego is such a fan of art that he would be able to see the beauty in this. It might be a little limiting, though, on fashion that we could put on the dog. So for that reason, I know it's superficial. We're gonna keep looking. Oh, look at this little guy. Oh my gosh, I love this simmer. So, I'm so sorry, I'm gonna butcher this. Onyeric N? Their gallery ID plus the gallery ID of the other simmer that we were looking at are going to be in the description below in case you want to look them up on the gallery. I love the amount of effort that they put into this description. So this is Frida, the mini Sholo, aka Mexican hairless dog. Aztec legend is that Sholoit, god of fire, lightning, and death, created the Aztec word for dog, tasked as spirit guides through the underworld. History of the Sholo dates back 3,000 years. Not only are they one of the world's oldest breeds, they are also one of the rarest. If not for the Sholo expedition of 1954, Sholos would likely be extinct. I love all of the effort put into this description. You guys, when you upload to the gallery, please include a description. I love to see you guys's thought processes, and I know that I'm not alone. Nothing kills a beautiful creation like having no background on it. So let's place this household. This is going to be the miniature version. Oh my goodness, it's got the little speckling here. This on their head, like the freckles, that's pretty characteristic. That is so gorgeous. So this is a female named Frida. I absolutely love that. Let's keep it. And this Frida is a sleuth. She is loyal and she is vocal. I want to change that actually a little bit for her. I definitely agree with the loyal. I think that Diego would spoil his dog so much they couldn't be anything but. Vocal. Yeah, we can do that for sure. Maybe she could be playful. What, ma'am, are you going to be wearing? Should we go with a colorful little dress and bow? Is red more your color? I feel like these are pretty conventional. I don't know that Diego would love... Oh my gosh, a little onesie. Oh my goodness. Oh, I love it. Very colorful. Okay, very striking against her dark skin. And can I get a purple collar for this dog? Absolutely. Actually, I think we're going to do this one because, again, I love the studs. I think that that's beautiful. All right, Miss Frida, we have you there. I see you. Let's go back to the gallery because I do want a standard size because, again, he is... he's got the means, we'll put it that way. Oh, this guy looks so cute. So this is titled Mexican Hairless Dog. It is uploaded by Lexi0203. She actually has a few versions of these dogs. Let's pop this little dog into our game. Oh my goodness, how cute. So it looks like this is a female as well. I don't disagree with that. I think that he would want some female dogs, his little girls around him. So his first little girl was named Frida. His second could be Linda. Linda is Spanish for beautiful. So far, Linda is friendly. I agree with that. She could be a couch potato. And let's make her stubborn. I think that Diego would really respect a girl that knows what she wants. And if she just doesn't want to listen right now, oh well. So, Miss Linda, what are we going to do for you? Let's do a collar and let's see, her dress Big dogs only have one option. I'm liking the plaid. I love the flowers. Oh my goodness, I love the flowers. That's so cute. And it's nice and bright. It would get attention, and Linda would be serving it all day long. That kind of matches, but would he try to stand out with a green or maybe a blue? I think I do. I like this blue on her. See, now I want to make the match. All right, let's do a blue and yellow moment, and then let's change that collar up. Yeah, or blue and orange moment. Yes. Okay, so both of his little girls are in their beautiful dresses. And there you have it, guys. San Myshuno is now a much furrier, happier place. I hope these guys really enjoy their furry friends and that they can get their New Year's resolutions started with a little bit of help from them. And that's going to do it pretty much for the video today. I am thinking about doing one of these every month and picking households that kind of correlate with the themes of these months. So let me know what you think of that down in the comments. Let me know too what you think of each household's personality. Did I pick the same kind of animal that you would have? I'm very interested to know what you guys would have paired with each household. Thank you guys so much for taking time to watch this. I will see you in the next one. And as always, happy simming.